Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbell.rocks. Today we're going to show you how to use Whiteboard in grid view, and I'm going to show you what it looks like on your end as the teacher and then on the student's end, so what they see as well. So let's jump in and get started. So I am in a Google Meet that I've set up through Google Classroom, which is an awesome tool that they've added the past couple of days. And you'll see, obviously it's the same picture, but I'm logged in on this side as myself and this side as my student. Okay, so I'm going to open up a Jamboard here. And if you're unfamiliar with Jamboard, it's a Google Classroom tool that you can use to draw and collaborate and share and kind of an idea. You can set up different backgrounds and different things like that. I won't spend a ton of time on that. But what I want to show you is then I'm going to slide over, and this is the student's view. So the student also has grid view, and these are flopped, right? So the presenter's over here and the student's right here. So as the teacher, I open up Jamboard. Now, what I'm going to do as the teacher is I am going to present my screen. And instead of my entire screen, I'm going to select a window. It's going to pop up what window I want to show. I want to show the Jamboard window here. And what's going to happen right up here is it's going to open up a new window and it's going to say you're presenting. I'm still going to be able to see the student here and myself. If I want, I could include myself, unclick myself, and I'll be able to see the student here, right? If I slide over to here, the student will now be able to see themselves, the teacher, and the Jamboard, right? And all the other students that are in this meet. So I'm just going to do a little test, right? You'll see some pop-ups going back and forth. It's showing me that I'm still presenting. So I'm just going to write here. It's harder with a trackpad than it is with a mouse, right? I can change this. Let's highlight this, maybe make it a little bit bigger. We'll do green. So this is what I'm working on now, but live over on the student side, they're going to be able to see exactly what I'm doing on Jamboard. And that's shared with the whole class, right? If the student does not have grid view installed, the grid view extension installed, this is what it looks like for them. They are just going to see the Jamboard. That's it. All right. So if the students want to see you and the Jamboard and all the other students in the class, they need to have the grid view extension. If not, they'll just see the Jamboard. Again, this is what it looks like for the teacher, right? Now I'm done presenting. So I'm going to turn this off. I'm going to stop presenting. If I go back to the student side, to the student view, they're just going to see me as the teacher. So again, one of the workarounds, and I don't know if I found necessarily a workaround yet, is to see what you're working on while you're presenting to the students. You want to be able to see the students and what you're presenting. I assume that Google's going to be working on that, especially what's happening right now, everybody being home and doing schooling from home and the shutdown. Again, if you have questions, go ahead and email me, make comments. If this brought value to you, if you learned something new, if it's going to save you time, energy, and frustration, again, go ahead and subscribe, because most of the things that I will do will be for teachers to help bring value to you. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.